On average, wood contains around 10 times more calories per kilogram than fruit or leaves. Yet while animals across the animal kingdom eat almost every part of trees, leaves, fruits, flowers, seeds, heck, even their internal fluids, the wood is almost exclusively eaten by a few insects. What's keeping all those other animals from dining on, well, the dining table? While wood is made up of the same nutritious carbohydrate called cellulose that makes up other tasty tree parts, most of the cellulose in wood is bound together by a complex molecule called lignin. This makes wood super strong on both the molecular level and the macro level. So wood is hard to eat because it's literally hard. Some animals, like beavers, have the right masticating machinery, like sharp teeth and strong jaws, to break wood down on the macro level, which does release about a third of the yummy cellulose, but the rest is not digested and gets pooped out still tangled up in the lignin. Insects like termites can go whole hog on the whole log because they can chew the wood with their serrated mandibles and also have the right gut machinery, aka microbes, to break the lignin down on the molecular level. Because lignin evolved in part to help plants defend themselves against attackers, mainly independently living microbes, lignin has mostly stymied microbes' attempts to break it down. But life finds a way, and a few million years after the evolution of lignin, a few microbes finally untangled the mystery. We still don't understand all the details, but some microbes seem to produce enzymes that use oxygen to break the tight bonds in lignin molecules, setting the cellulose free, to be eaten, which is actually how wood decomposes. In order for termites and a few other insects to digest wood, they had to turn those independently living lignin-breaking microbes into gut-living lignin-breaking microbes. We aren't sure why more animals haven't been able to put these microbes to work for them. Perhaps it's because their guts don't have the right chemical composition, or because other biota already living there are hostile towards newcomers. Or maybe termites are just early adopters and millions more years of evolution will lead to more diversity of wood-eating animals. Who knows, maybe one day woodchucks will chuck wood into their mouths. This video is sponsored by the Okinawa Institute of Science and Technology Graduate University, an international graduate school devoted to the advancement of science, education, and innovation in Japan and throughout the world. OIST offers a fully funded PhD program and research internship opportunities that attract talented young scientists from around the world to work with researchers like Professor Tom Bourguignon, whose evolutionary genomics lab investigates how insects manage to conquer the world, both in terms of animal biomass and biodiversity. The lab's research on termite gut microbe DNA actually informed this video, as they've been able to map how the wood-digesting microbes actually evolved, discovering that some microbes only exist within termites. To learn more about OIST, or maybe even apply, visit admissions.oist.jp.